What's up, guys? Welcome back to Andy Plays DGV. We're here for week 7 out of 8 of the Royal Cup. We've got Emporia Country Club back 9, Nokia Beast back 9, Maple Hill front 9, and Northern Lights. Not played that much this week, and I was doing a little bit of warm-up earlier, and I'm not playing very well. Of course, as always, the goal is top 50. But I don't have much hope. Let's just have a quick look at what top 50 score is at the moment. All right, so top 50, we need to shoot. There's 37, 37 is 54. So we need to shoot 24 under to get to top 50. All right, so 24 under is the target. Let's see how we do. Starting off with Emporia. Back 9. Lots of OB to be found on this course. Ripping right to left wind here. Take the Sapphire, aim down low, and give it some Anhyzer to fight the wind and hopefully stay in bounds. This looks okay actually. Just outside the circle. 15 meters into a headwind. But no problem, we get the birdie on one. All right, hole 2. Another Sapphire hole, glide Sapphire. Let's aim a little bit out to the right here. And hopefully the fade will bring it back. It does. And 18 meters out. And in for birdie. Off to hole 3. Let's go, backhand. Accurate roll, Sapphire. Aim at this tree and then flex it underneath this one. Up to the basket. And inside the circle for an 8-meter putt. Okay, first 3 holes are the easy ones. Now this course gets hard. Okay, we're gonna go rive. Couldn't think of the name of the disc there. Try and hang it out over the OB. Trust the stability of the disc. This looks okay. This looks very nice actually. For another 8-meter putt. In for birdie. Off to hole 5. Okay, probably the hardest hole on the back 9. I like to take the flippy skippy driver, the paradigm. Aim a little bit over here. And about half a disc's worth of hyzer. Turn. And skip. And slightly flirting with the OB line there, but that's actually a really good place. We want to be kind of, squashed up to the OB line here, because then we can take water skip to give us a bit of ground play, and hopefully just follow the OB and go around this tree. About half a disc of hyzer, just over half a disc of hyzer. From over the tree. Oh, lucky. Oh, sit. Sit. Not behind the bush though. So a little bit of luck there to ride the OB line, but we are stuck behind the bush here. Let's see if we can get this round something like this. No. Oh yeah. I don't mind taking par on this hole actually. It's a tricky hole. I think par is probably what the majority of people are getting on that hole. Okay, 150. So, glide Sapphire again. Little bit of Anhyzer just to flex it. And slide up here. A little bit shorter than I want to be. 23 meters out. It's a little bit downhill. But we made it. Okay, off the hole 7. This one's a tricky one, and it's a big headwind. Okay, so I'm going to take the roll rive. I know a lot of people aim super far down, but I find that often hits the bank and jumps over the back. So what I like to do is just power down, and I'm going to go big Anhyzer on this to lean into the wind. Come on, get up, get up, get up. There we go. Okay, and safely against the back fence for a putt. For birdie, off to hole 8. This first shot is always quite tricky here. I think I'm going to throw the sapphire. Kind of a bit of a choice between the sapphire or the roll rive. This wind's going to push me towards the Mando, so I'll try and put Hyzer on it to fight it. There we go, but hopefully not too much that we go out of bounds. It's a skinny fairway. Now we're in good position. I'm 138 into the pin. It's quite downhill. I think I'm going to take the roll rive on a forehand and kind of push out here and then let the wind take it. And the tree helping us majorly there, because I think we could have been in trouble otherwise. 21 out with the tailwind, something like that. Oh, high chains. Oh, I counted it. Wow, that was quite the spit out. But we got away with that one. I like to take the roll sapphire, default aim. Actually, I might aim down a little bit because of the wind. And looking to get to the FPO tee, just on the right-hand side here. There you go, that's a good place to be. And then 122 in, it should be accurate roll glide sapphire. Gonna put quite a bit of hyzer because of the wind, and don't want any chance of flirting with the water. Do we have a putt? No, we don't. But we are downwind at least. Nice. Okay, so a relatively clean Emporia back nine, just missing out on the birdie on 5, but other than that, clean. Nice. Okay. Not too bad. Happy with that. Off to Nokia next. I'm just going to take a quick break. We'll be back in one moment. All right, time for Nokia the Beast's back nine. Let's jump in. Let's get ready for some tree hits. Ooh, interesting wind here. Do I still go with the sapphire or do I go with the rive? It's a headwind, so I think I want the overstability of the rive. Now because of that, I'm going to aim a little bit further. Oh no, the wind's pushing us though. Oops, wrong bit. There we go. Let's just try a straight pullback. The aim is to get inbounds from this first shot. Oh, this could be going long. Oh, no, I think we're okay. Okay, it's 138 into a headwind. I think we're going to have to go rive again. And aim down, get it under the wind. Oh, that's turned massively. Oh no, that's so out of bounds. Oh, saved by the light pole. Oh wow, that was in trouble otherwise. Let's just keep this inbounds and lay up next to the basket, or slightly behind the basket, and take a par. Tricky hole, that one. I struggle with it quite a bit. So par is not too bad. Better than a bogey. Okay, continuing with ripping winds. I'm going to take the water skip Gould. I like it on this hole. And then give it a little bit of Anhyzer. You can also throw the sapphire on this hole. Oh, stop, 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 stop. Oh, okay, safe. The sapphire just leaves you a bit shorter, whereas the gold will take you longer, or right up to the basket sometimes. Okay, off to hole 3. We get the birdie there. Okay, Wind has decided to stop. Go forehand, up this gap here. Glide, skip, arrive. And, oh dear. Oh, generous kick there to put us back into the middle of the fairway. 79 to the pin. I think it's Claymore. And let's try and highs this round there. That looks nice. Very nice indeed for a little tap in. Pat. Good. Good, good, good. Okay. Off to hole four. Par four. And the wind is back. This one's tricky. It's all about getting through this tunnel. And I'm going to try and give myself as much room as possible. Give a little bit of Anheuser as well. Hopefully miss this tree. Well, we caught the cabbage, but that's okay. We didn't kick off the tree. And that's not a bad position, actually. I can see the basket, which is good. So we've got a chance at a throw in here. I don't have much hope for this throw in. Oh, long. I'm lucky to hit the stump there in the bush. We get the birdie. Would have been nice to have got the eagle there, but in that wind, it was going to be tricky. Okay, this hole. Lots of strong wind today. This hole, I actually like to go forehand. Reason being, with the rive as well, especially in this headwind, reason being is we have a staggered gap here that we have to hit. This tree is closer. That tree is further away. So if we like hyzer it or flex it through the gap, it's easier on a forehand than it is on a backhand. The backhand wants to hit this tree first. And also the rive on a, you know, the reduction in power of throwing forehand with the rive is a nice distance. Something like that, I guess. So flex it through the gap up there and stop pin high next to the basket for a nice birdie. Sweet. Okay, off to hole six. This one's a tricky one. Thank goodness, no wind. This hole is a menace if there's wind. So I like to take the accurate glide sapphire. I'm going to try and skip the sapphire over the little creek that leads to the lake. Let's see if we can get this. Turn. Hopefully doesn't catch the tree. It doesn't. Glide, glide, glide. Oh, no. Ah. It glided. Glided just a little bit too much. Kind of wanting to hit the bank, kind of where I am now, to skip across. Now we're stuck with quite a tricky throw in to get to save the par. Okay. Come down to the right like that. That looks good. High chains, but we made it. Oh, save the par. Thank goodness. Okay, off to hole seven. AB hole. I used to struggle with this hole a lot. But rives definitely help. You want to throw an overstable disc on this hole. Like that. This looks to be very nice. And in the middle of the fairway, perfect. Okay, 78 meters. I'm pretty sure the Claymore will be able to get there, especially in a tailwind. But ideally, you want to come into this green on a forehand so that you're using these hay bales over here as a backstop and not going long. I'm slightly worried that the Claymore is just going to skip long. So I think I'm going to aim a little higher so that it comes in a little softer. We do have a tailwind as well, which should help with the distance. Okay, stop. Stop. Oh, cutting it close. Glad I raised the aim point up there. Okay, we get the birdie. Okay, off to hole 8. This hole, flippy skippy driver, aim down on forehand. And then just a little bit of hyzer. And the wind is pushing that a little more than a two wind really should, in my opinion. Downhill into tailwind, something like that. Yes. Try not to overthink the putt. Okay, off to hole 9. I can hear the wind. Okay. What to do? Without the tail, in a one wind, I'd take the glide roll rive, kind of go along this OB line here and aim to end up next to kind of that tree over there. But with this tailwind, I think actually it's better to throw the sapphire on a forehand. Yeah, let's try that. Turn, stay in bounds. Oh dear. Oh, we stayed in bounds. Whew. Phew. Now I'm going to take the roll sapphire, aim at the scoreboard sign, give it some anhyzer to lean into the wind, let the fade come round. There we go. Hopefully we'll have a putt. We do. Just aim up a touch because it's a raised basket. And we get the birdie on hole 9. So, nice 7 under for Nokia. So that puts us at 15 under. Wait, what? Got 8 on the first one? Yeah. Yeah, so 15 under so far. So we need 9 under across the next 2 courses. That doesn't seem right. Well, we'll see. We'll do our best. I'm going to take a quick break again, and I'll be back for Maple Hill in one moment. Okay, time for Maple Hill front nine. Off we go. Now, off the tee here, I actually like to throw my flippy skippy driver. The paradigm. Bit of hyzer to give it some stability and hit the path. Oh, nice kick off the tree there, and we are up there. 71 meters coming into the green. I think I'm going to throw the heart on a forehand. I think power it down a little bit and just get in there nice and close to the basket for birdie on hole 1. Nice way to start. Off to hole 2. No wind, which is nice. I'm going to take the glide sapphire. Straight pullback. And up against these signs here. Ooh, 25 meters is a little further than I really want to be throwing it in from. Oh, just sneaking it over the rim there. Off to hole 3. This one's a tricky one. Yeah, not a huge fan of this hole. It's tough. Yeah, let's just throw sapphire on a forehand. Hope for the best. Well, that's turned loads. I hit a couple of stumps. And that's about as good as I can want from that. Now, this throw-in is really tricky. Or it's a throw-in that I massively struggle with. It's probably a better way of putting it. But this looks amazing. Yes! We hit the birdie. Oh, I'm stoked. I'm stoked about that. Yay. I was fully expecting a par there. Okay. Iconic hole here. Gonna take the putter. aim down at the basket like this and take power off. The last thing I want to do is go into the water at the bottom. Powering down should stop that, although had me scared for a moment there. Aim up a little bit more to get the throw in. Uphill throw in off to hole 5. Across the lake. And the wind is pushing against us. Glide sapphire or roll sapphire? I think I'm going to go glide sapphire. I don't want to risk it. Let's aim up. I just said glide sapphire. Let's give it lots of hyzer to force it round. This looks nice. Okay, and 14 meters, aim up a bit. In for birdie. Nice, off the hole 6 we go. Okay, forehand, glide sapphire, aim down this stump. And this wind, let's give it some hyzer. And come round. And there we go, resting behind the tree. Yeah, we can slide out from behind it. 12 meters. Okay, good. Another birdie. Off to hole 7. Okay, we've got wind again. Let's go glide sapphire. Try and open up the fairway a little bit. And almost a straight pullback with this try and put a bit of hyzer on it because of the wind. Oh, nice kick off the tree. Helpful kick off the tree, actually. But quite the throw in now. Aim slightly to the left of the basket. That's short. Oh no, it's not way. Yes, snuck it over the ring. I did not like that out of the hand. That was not looking good out of the hand. Okay, this one's a tricky one. Okay, there's no wind. Oh. Okay, no wind. Go for the sapphire. Okay, add some anhyzer to flex it. Should be enough. It is enough. Yep. Ooh, gap in the fence is calling, but we managed to avoid it. The inbounds, that's the main thing. And in for birdie. Now off to the hardest hole on the course. And I'm going to slide to the left to open it up a little bit more. Flippy skippy driver. The wind is helping us here as well. Well, that didn't turn at all. Okay. Not great. Not great. Long way out. I think I just kind of lay up here. I think I just take the warship. Try and get kind of down the hill. Take a little bit off it, maybe. Oh, we've stayed in bounds. Oh my goodness, my heart was in my mouth. There. Oh my goodness. Okay. Crosswind, 22 meters. Something like that. Nice. And we get a clean Maple Hill. We get a clean round through Maple Hill. Oh, this is good. This is good. Okay. Going to the last one, Northern Lights. And as it's been working for me so far, I'm going to take a break and I'll be back in a moment. Alright, I'm back. And, unless my maths is terrible, 8 plus 7 is 15, plus 9 is 24. I just rechecked the scores a moment ago. 24 is the cutoff for top 50. So I think we might be there. The leader is 33. So if I shoot 9 under through Northern Lights, we could be in the lead, or joint lead. I don't have the confidence to shoot 9 under through Northern Lights, but we'll see. I'm just going to do my best, take it one hole at a time, And also, I've just noticed we should get a level up at the end of this as well, which will be a nice end to the video. So, Northern Lights, off we go. This first hold is tricky, especially in this headwind, but I like to take the flippy skippy driver. Aim up is what I found helps get over the hill. A little bit of all that's turned massively. Okay, so not great position to start with. Should be able to scramble to get the birdie. I'm going to throw the half, I think, on the forehand. That should get us round there. Ah, oh, not that far, actually. Oh, dear. Okay, I think I'm laying this up. And just take my par. Just take my par. There we go. Hole two. If I just shoot par the whole way through this course, I think I'll still be happy. Ooh, ripping wind. Okay, so I take the Explorer on a forehand. Normally I'd aim at this light. Because of this wind, I'm going to aim further out and take a little bit off it. Let's go straight pull back. As the wind will push it and stops it right there. Okay, that's cool. That's cool. That's cool. That's a good place. Uphill a bit. Oh, I'm glad I noticed that that twig was in front of the basket. Uphill with a tailwind. How much is it going to lift it? We'll see. Okay, in. Phew. So we get birdie. On to hole three. Yeah. Possibly the hardest hole on the course. I don't know. The par five is also pretty hard. Sapphire. Aim at the rocks. And it will take you to the middle of the fairway, which it does. And then same disc again on a forehand, aim at the tree, little bit of hyzer, and the fade should go with the fairway. And we're behind the rock. Okay, once again quite far out. I think I'm just going to lay this up. Just stay clean. Take our birdies when we can. Don't take extra risks. Off to hole four. No wind. Nice. Glide Sapphire again. Straight pull back. Oh, quite far right on the right side of the fairway. Ooh, I'm not used to being down here, I have to say. I don't know which side to go around. I think we'll go this way. I'm not sure if the Sapphire will get there, you know? Just throw the rive just to be safe. There's a lot of backstop behind the basket. So I don't mind going long. Although the tree might have blocked us. No, we're okay. We're okay. We're okay. And 15. In for birdie. Pick up another birdie. Nice. Off to hole 5. And the wind's back. I like to aim just straight down the middle on a backhand with the claymore. I'm kind of aiming to slide through these trees here. Ooh. Kick by the rock. 25 meters out. Cross headwind. And we make it. Nice. Pick up another birdie. Off to hole 6. Par 3. Some default aim. Bit of Anheuser. Don't hit the tree. Oh, thank goodness. And we made it to the landing zone. And we're nowhere near the tree either, which is nice, because that can complicate the putt sometimes. Pick up another birdie. Last three holes. My palms are sweaty. Knees weak, arms are heavy. Okay, let's go glide rive. And let's put a load of hyzer on this because I don't want to go long. Okay, cool. This is looking nice. This is looking nice. Okay, cool. Just behind the drop zone. And then we want to go forehand. Sapphire. Give it a load of hyzer. Let's get into the fairway. Or onto the island, I should say. And then I'm going to throw the rive around the back. Once again, there's lots of backstops, so I don't mind going long, but I hit the bush and got away with it. Oh my goodness. Now, sometimes you need a bit of luck, and that was most definitely a bit of luck. Oh, thought I was going to chain out to the left there. You get the birdie. Nice. Two holes to go. Two holes to go. This one's a tricky one. Oh, especially in this wind. Okay. I'm going to go rive and fight the wind. This looks good. This looks good. This is good. Okay, I don't mind being next to the house there. The wind is actually quite a helping wind for this second shot. How far are we? 140. So let's go high and kind of spike hyzer. Through. Oh! I thought. Okay, a little bit pinched off. So let's just lay up and take our par. Off to hole 9. Keeping it clean. Okay. I like to take the accurate glide sapphire, aim at the top of this house and this wind, give it some hyzer. And I think I've mentioned it before, but the sapphire lands nicely between these trees and without risk of getting pinched off behind or near the tractor over there, which can stop your putt or block you off from your putt. And we make it. Okay, so is that 6 under? 6 under and clean. All 4 rounds clean. No bogeys, which is super good. Come on, give us our we made it by 11 points. Cool. Okay, let's see what we get. Fuse, gold, and trust. Turn glide gold. Yep, I think I'm just going to take that one. I'm not going to re-roll it. Yeah, okay. And we get reward. Dagger, Keystone, XXX. Once again, I'm not going to re-roll them. Take the XXX. Why not? Let's have a look at the standings. There we are. Tied in third place. So, I think we've still got a couple of hours left yet. But I think I've finally done it. I think I finally made top 50 in a DGV PT. Wow, I am stoked, guys. I have to say, I was not expecting that on these courses. Like I said, I've not been playing that well up until now, but everything worked out. Didn't take any bogeys, and yeah, pretty happy. Thank you very much for watching this video. Give me a like. Come on, I made top 50. It's taken me 7 weeks. I think that deserves a like. And while you're at it, why not subscribe? And I'll be back for some multiplayer during the week. And so I'll see you then. Bye-bye for now.